I put the other elements on, and I've got the number 10 by 1 3/4 inch long machine screw, and a nut and a split lock washer to go on the back side of it. This element really could use another lock washer in between the element and the boom to help kind of keep it from spinning around. So I don't have any on hand, any little star washers, or you know, I think either an internal or external tooth lock washer, either one would help out. Just something to help kind of keep it from getting, you know, from spinning. And once it's tightened down, it's not really going to move unless it gets bumped. So I wouldn't worry about the wind necessarily. Just try to keep from bumping it. Go ahead and get all these started, and then I'll tighten them up. And of course, the mounting clamp is going to go on the opposite side of the feed point. Put the mast on this side. Could put it on this side, but put it on this side. Find the holes. D2. I'm putting it with the seam towards the boom. So there is my 5-element 70 centimeter Yagi all put together, and as you can see, it was really pretty simple to make. The tricky part is now is just going to be adjusting the gamma match. I move the antenna out towards the center of the room, and I'll sit over at the table and take some notes. I'll take an SWR reading every megahertz or so across the 70 centimeter band and take a few notes and compare the SWRs. Of course, when I get this outside and get it up in the air, everything's going to be different. And so I'm going to do this indoors just to see if I can get it close. And then later I'll take it outdoors and test it outdoors. I have my handy talkie plugged into the SWR meter and the antenna. And I've got the battery charged up, but the meter says I'm only doing about 1 watt out, and also the meter on the radio also reflects about the same amount of power coming out. 2 meters, I've got 5 watts coming out, but on 70 centimeters, not as much power. And it takes at least 3 watts to get an accurate reading on this SWR meter, and which I'm not getting. I have already tried to sweep across the band, and I'm getting the same reading on each frequency. Let's see, this is, I got the handy talkie set at 444.875, and I've got the shift turned off, so I'm at almost 445 megahertz. I key the microphone. And there you see it. I'm showing 1 watt, and then a little bit of a reflective power, not enough. But I don't have enough power going into the meter to tell and to get a real accurate reading here. And I have already tried sliding the tube up and down, and the grounding strap also up and down on the antenna. And of course, I'm still getting about the same SWR reading, no matter how many changes I make to the antenna. So. It appears to be working. I'm just going to have to buy a new analyzer that also does 440, or buy a more powerful 440 rig and try that. But I can kind of demonstrate the antenna using the handy talkie, and so let me try to do that here. Let's put the rubber duck back on the HT. And I am at 444.825, which, if I've got this right, this is the Lecompton, Kansas repeater. Keep in mind, I am closer to Kansas City than I am Topeka. And Lawrence, Kansas is about 20 miles to the west of me. And Lecompton, Kansas is even farther west. It is halfway between Lawrence and Topeka. And so I'm going to try the handy-talkie with the rubber duck and see if I can bring up the repeater from sitting right here. KG0ZZ. Nothing. KG0ZZ. Okay, let me try holding the handy-talkie up higher. KG0ZZ. Absolutely nothing. Let's try this with the little Yagi antenna, and I've got it sitting right here, right behind me. I can get this in here. Get that plugged in. All right, let's try the repeater now. KG0ZZ. I've got it full scale. Some of the little bars are out here on my radio. I'll bring this up again, but I'm into it full scale. KG0ZZ. I don't know if you can see it there. Turn the volume up. Well, the antenna is working. I can take it outdoors and test it, and I'm sure it'll work even better. Radio's not heating up any. The only thing I can do is get some more equipment if I really want to get serious about playing with 70-centimeter antennas. So for me, 70 centimeters is kind of I'm at a disadvantage because I don't really have the equipment to do a lot of testing for 70 centimeters and really fine-tune the antenna. But just out of luck, I have put together a Yagi antenna that is working, and I think once I'm able to read exactly what it says on the meter, then I'll be able to fine-tune the antenna. So guys, I guess that's it. We'll save taking it out for another day. If somebody wants to send me a new MFJ antenna analyzer with a 70 centimeter band built in, I'm good in the call book. So guys, 7-3, I'll see you later down the log from KG0ZZ.